everyone, how are you doing today? Come and join me as I go through my most ambitious TBR that I have ever done on this channel. When I say ambitious, I mean ambitious. These are just some of the books. I've got about another four more to add to this pile. Am I currently in the worst reading slump that I've been in about 3 years? Yes. Am I adding more books than I've ever read to any TBR and more books than I've ever read in a month? Also yes. It's gonna be fun. Not only that, but I'm taking part in not one, not two, but three readathons. So I'm taking part in the Magical Readathon by Book Roast, the Mixtape Summer Mixtape-a-thon, which is, can't remember all of the hosts, but I know that Jean Bookish Thoughts and What Victoria Read are taking part and are involved in the creation of this. The final one is the Tropical Readathon that I try to do at least once a year by Jen Jen Reviews and her partner Rob. And what I'm going to do to make this video easier, rather than show you each book and tell you which readathon I'm reading it for, I'm going to go by readathon. That way, if you want to see what all of the books I'm reading are, you can go through all of the readathons. If you just want to find out one particular readathon, then you can just skip ahead to the readathon that you are either interested in or take a part in or whatever. So I'm just gonna get on with the readathons starting now. Just like magic, quick change. The first of the readathons is the Mixtape-a-thon, and I'm doing this one first because A, it's summery and August is summer, and B, it's the shortest, so I can just get this one done really quickly. I'm just gonna put some information up here, so we've got the prompts. Editing Kirsty, just to say, I didn't pay enough attention, but I completely missed that they're not all book prompts. Some of them are prompts for you to do extra bits, so only the four corners are book prompts. So there are bits of this video that I cut out because originally I put books in, so they're now not. But all the things like self-care, summer movie, all of that, I will just vlog about. I'm not actually going to go through the prompts, so I'm just going to go through the four prompts that I need for this readathon. The reason I wanted to do this one, first of all, I thought the colour scheme was brilliant. And in my reading journal, I haven't yet finished it, but I used the colours and the inspiration from the mixtape for my cover page that I'm still currently working on. But I have pulled all of the summary books off my shelves for this and the tropical reads to just try and give a little bit more sunny, happy vibes. And I am going to kickstart this with the first prompt, which is a book that has nature on the cover. I have gone with This Vicious Grace because it's got leaves and it's got, oh no, I think they're more leaves, but it looks like lemons. And I think the book underneath also is really, really pretty because it also has leaves on the spine. Then is a spicy book, and I've chosen Fortuna Swan, which I'm slightly regretting choosing. Then I quite like this prompt, so it's an unseasonal read. And so I've chosen the Icy Pirates, and this is a middle grade, and obviously it's icy and it's winter and it's set in the Arctic. Well, a fantasy land, but very Arctic land. So, and it's literally called the Ice Sea, so that's very unseasonal for the middle of summer. And then the final prompt for this readathon is a book set in a different country, and again I wanted not only another country, but I also wanted a book that gave me sort of summery vibes and like was a bit light. And I've gone with Cafe Con Lychee. It's set in America. Look how sunny, like this gives summer vibes. Look at it, the colours, the baked goods, the book underneath, which does normally just slide out. The book underneath is bright yellow and sunny and summer, so I think I'm gonna love the vibes that I get from this book. So that is my mixtape readathon, which I plan on, every time I read one of these books, I plan on listening to like summery music, and I want to read as many of these outside as I can to really make the most of it being summer. That's the summer, the summer mixtape-a-thon. Moving on, we have the tropical readathon. So I thought I'd wear my Camp Pusheen t-shirt where it's got like the tropical green colours and it feels very summery. And this is one that I've done for a few years now, and every year I try to be on a different team. This year I am on Team Romance, which is a bit different. So again, I've tried to pick books that have got more of a romance theme, but they're not all romance. And like I said, some of these might be the same as what we've already seen, some of these will be new. But I'm kickstarting with the team prompts, and the first team prompt is the friend to lover trope, and I am going with Delilah Green Doesn't Care, because from what I understand, these, I don't know if they start as friends, but I am aware that they know each other at least, and it's someone coming home, and it's at least someone she knows. So I'm just gonna go with this one, and if it doesn't quite fit, then whatever, it doesn't have to be exact. Then we have the bodyguard trope, and this is one of the books that appears in every readathon that I'm doing, and so that will be This Vicious Grace. The reason I really wanted this one is because it literally says, desperate to survive, Alessa hires Dante, a cynical outcast marked as a killer, to become her personal bodyguard. Sorted. So those were the two team books. There's also the team challenges. There's also like the team read, but I've decided I'm probably not going to read that because that requires me buying another book and I already have too many books to get through. I'm just going to do the team prompts and then the as many of the 13 regular challenge prompts as I can. So for the regular challenges, we've got each one you get two choices. So if you don't quite want to do the main prompt, you can do the alternate prompt. So some of these are the main prompt, some of these are the alternate. I didn't write down which one I've picked. I will just tell you which of the prompts I chose along with the book. And the very first one is a book with multiple authors. For that, I have chosen The Forgotten and the Fantastical, Volume 3. This is a short story fantasy retellings collection, and my friend Sarah is actually published in this. So I thought that would be a really good one because it's many different authors who have put their stories into this book. We then have a love triangle. I don't know if it actually is a love triangle and I don't want to check in case I get spoiled, but I Kissed Shara Wheeler, I think. Like, it talks about at the very beginning, it's like, you know, she's not the only one that Shara kissed. So that tells me there's going to be at least some sort of multiple romance thing going on there. And again, this just has such summery vibes. Look at it. It's got your bright pink and lipstick and the blue and the sunny, and it just gives me tropical vibes. Next up is a genre that I don't usually read, and for that I'm going back to middle grade and I'm going back to the Ice Sea Pirates. Of the 200 and something books I've got listed on my Goodreads, only about 12 of them are middle grade, and I do want to read more middle grade, so I'm going to kickstart with this. Then we have a dystopia, and for this I am choosing The Stranded by my friend Sarah Daniels. I've not finished it yet, but I did get about halfway through the arc and I was loving it, so I can't wait to reread the first half and get back and finish it. Next we have a retelling, and for this is my buddy read that I'm doing with my friend that starts on the first, which is Daughter of Darkness by Catherine and Elizabeth Kaur. And you can see I've already marked off the days that we're going to be reading, and yeah, this is a Greek mythology retelling, so I'm very much looking forward to it. Then we have an audio or an ebook, and for this I'm going to be reading the ebook The Bromance Book Club, and this is not a book that I would have ever picked up on my own. However, I've joined a reading group that Shah from Thoroughly Enjoy Books recommended to me, and I have been in the group for 3 months and I've not yet managed to read the books in that they've picked. So this will be the first time that I've actually bought the book and will be reading it. The next book is a book that has bookish themes in it, and I figured that the best choice I could make is a reread of Fables Volume 1. And this is essentially a bunch of fairy tale characters, which is pretty bookish, that are in New York. You know, it's a comic book about book characters, so that's very bookish. Then there's a book published pre-2000, which is another one of my books. It's in all three readathons, and that is The Alchemist. This one was published in 1988 and is obviously pre-2000. Next up, we had either multiple point of view or multiple people of colour. I went with multiple people of colour and I chose another summery book because it's set in the summer. And it's got a very summery, it's the Fairy Loot edition, so it's got like these beautiful lilac pages and it's got this very summery feel to the book. I thought I would choose This Poison Heart as it's all about flowers and it's set in summer, so why not? We then had a holiday read, and I couldn't really not pick beach read for this, could I? Because it's a beach, and where do you go on holiday? Not all the time, but where do a lot of people go on holiday? The beach. And then the final book in this one is either features a celebrity or is a celebrity recommended book. I'm going with Flashfire by TJ Klune, which is book two in the Extraordinary series. And the Extraordinaries are a bunch of superheroes who are celebrities. Yeah, this one features plenty of celebrities. And that is the final final pick for the Tropecore Readathon, where I really hope to do my team justice. And it's a shame that I won't be able to do the main team book, but I'm going to try and get through as many of these as possible so I can get our team as many points as possible. And that is the final for that one. So now we're moving on to my third and final readathon for August 2022. My final readathon is the Magical Readathon, hence the magical kind of celestial themed t-shirt. For this readathon, I'm in the Order of the Crescent. I am a earthling, changeling, and I am currently making my way to become a herbologist. I only need to complete 4 reading prompts. For this readathon, we had the spring equinox back in April, where we had 1 prompt per subject, and basically once you passed them, you were ready. And then in the autumn equinox, which is this one, there are 3 prompts per subject. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to start off with the ones that are pivotal that I have to read for my subject, then I'll go through the ones that I want to do as extras. So that's where we have this massive list and every single one of these books is going to feature. So I'm going to try and speed this up a little bit. For my main subject of alchemy, the first prompt is the basics of poisons. So to read a book that's on somebody else's worst list that I might enjoy, for this, I went on to JD Ray Reads. She did a video on like books that she didn't like, and I've picked Fortuna Swan from that list. It was toss up between that and Red Rising, but I chose Fortuna Swan. Book 2 is Psionic Amber, so to read a book that is orange, and I have gone for The Alchemist. Then I've decided I am gonna do the third prompt because the book that I've selected for that is also a manga, so very short, easy, quick to read. And unfortunately the manga is in the post and should have got here, but that again is Mao Volume 1. And then the other subject that I have to get a cue in, so the first 2 prompts, is Restoration. And we kickstart with Object Restoration, which is to read a book that only has 1 thing on the cover. I've chosen I Kissed Shara Wheeler. Yes, I know there are actually a few things on here, but really the main focus is just that one person. And honestly, it's the closest thing from any of these books. It's the closest thing that I've got. Then it's to read a book that's one of the oldest books on your TBR. And I've been nervous about this one, but I've gone with Poison Study by Maria V. Schneider. So those two, these 3 plus Mao, are the only books that I have to get read next month in order to complete the prompts from the Magical Readathon. So really, I'm hoping, I have been in a really bad reading slump, but I'm hoping I can get to these. So everything else now is just extra credit, me wanting to overachieve, and also it's going to be really funny next year when I do my birthday anniversary thing and go through to see if I have read all of them. It's probably going to lead to a lot more things where I get drawn from the punish prompts. So I'm just kind of screwing with myself at this point. I went through all the different subjects and I picked out the ones that I think I would be most excited to study at Irelium, and I am going to start with animal studies. The first book is The Study of Familiars, so that's to pick a book that features an animal companion or familiar, and I'm bringing back Forgotten and the Fantastical 3. Because this one actually has a story in it that says girl on a pied horse. So I'm just gonna go with this, like even if nothing else, having a horse, that counts as an animal companion. All of these have got familiars involved. So the next one is A Raven, and I'm going with Vespertine by Margaret Rogerson. It features one of my absolute favorite animals, which is a raven, and it's a white raven as well, which is just, And then the final one for this was a hare familiar, so to read a book that either has a bunny or hare in the title or on the cover. And I'm going to Fables Volume 1 because right on the back, I wasn't expecting it, but I was so happy when I saw it, there is a little pink rabbit And he is so cute and he's in a dress, or she, so that was perfect. Next up we had demonology, because I think demons are terrifying, but also if you could learn how to summon and control them, that would be absolutely incredible, and why wouldn't you? Unless there's like a really bad payoff for it, in that case don't. But I just think that'd be a really cool subject. First one is imp wrangling, which is to read a fantasy, and this is the third and final time you're gonna see it, but we have this vicious grace. Then was Charo, so Demon of Chaos, which honestly I think is what ADHD should be named, because we are demons of chaos and our brains are demonic, chaotic monsters. So that's what my vote is for renaming ADHD, is Demons of Chaos. And for this one, oh, we had to use a random number generator. Now my random number generator came in the form of my friends Yaz and Gary. I asked them, whoever answered first, I just said, pick a number between 1 and 5. And it was Yaz that picked number 3, so she picked for me Cafe Con Leche. Cafe Con Leche, oh my god, trying to speed up doesn't work. So thank you, Yaz. And then I've decided that the final prompt I wasn't interested in really, it was to read a book that's at risk of being unhauled. And I have excluded quite a few prompts from this that I'm just not really interested in doing. And as it's such a big reading list already, I didn't want to add to that. So I'm skipping that one. Then we had elemental studies, because, you know, I'm an earthling in the house of the Order of the Crescent, so I need to really learn about the elements. And the very first one of this is Element of Water, which is to start a book with a drink. And I've picked this one, which is God of Neverland, and it's like Neverland is an island, so it's got water all around it. I'll be drinking with it, and I might sit and have a little paddling pool or something going. So I'll be like around water when I read it. Then we have wind redirection. So that was to point at a random book on your shelf and then go for the ones, one of the ones next to it. Can't remember what the third book was, but I know I pointed at Legendborn, and the book to the left of it was Flashfire, which I'd already picked out. So I am going with Flashfire. Final one for elemental is wave manipulation. And I'm going back with, there's only one, it's set. It's a dystopia. A virus has pushed everyone onto a cruise ship and they're now at sea. Enough said. The next subject that I would have been really, really excited to do is shapeshifting, because come on, turning into another animal, yes please. And the first one is the formation Wings, which is to read a book with wings on the cover. And I've picked a reread, which is Nimona by N.D. Stevenson. Why am I struggling with names? And Nimona herself has wings. We then have a book that was released this year, and I've picked The Butterfly Assassin by Finn Lonman, because it's released this year. And it just seems really interesting. I've read the first chapter and I cannot wait to get into the rest of this book. And then I have excluded the third and final prompt for shapeshifting, which is the word anatomy in the title. I don't have any books that fit, and even if I did, I probably wouldn't want to read them right now. So that one's out. And then we just basically have the subjects that I don't know if I would have picked, but I really like the prompt, so I've decided I'm just going to go for it anyway. And I'm going to kickstart with Conjuration, which is the founding of necromancy, which is a book that features necromantic themes, and I've gone for Daughter of Darkness because it's set in the underworld. The job title of the main character is the Soul Severer, so that kind of has necromancy type themes where you're dealing with death and the undead and all of this. Don't know about undead, but souls and death and things. And then I'm not doing any more for Conjuration. We then have The Art of Illusion, where I'm going for all three of these. And the first one is Blur Face, which is to read a book you don't know much about. Beach read, I actually, other than the title and the author, I can't tell you what this book is about. And I genuinely, I can't tell you. I'm assuming it's about going on holiday and reading books, but that's about all I can guess. Then we have Minor Illusion, which is to read a book under 300 pages. And another ebook, I'm going for Women Don't Owe You Pretty to fit this prompt. And then finally we have Deja Vu, which is to pick a prompt from the spring semester and redo it. I chose one of the prompts that I didn't do last semester, or I don't think I did, which was to read an essay or a collection of short stories. So I'm going to do that one, and that is going to be Blackberry Blue, which is a collection of fantasy short stories which I believe feature POC main characters. I don't know that for sure, but from the illustrations and what I've seen of it, it does look like that is the case. And I just think that'll be really, really interesting to read a middle grade that focuses on POC characters. Moving on to astronomy, which is a subject I don't know if I would. Oh, astrology I wouldn't want to do with divination and all that. But astronomy, yeah, I probably would do this one. So you got, for the first prompt is to read a book, is Lilivate, read a book with an L in the title. So I'm going with the Bromance Book Club. Q is Ravenspawn, so a book with archers or rangers. And I have to finish off the Greatcoats trilogy. So I've picked Tyrant's Throne by Sebastian de Castell because Brasty is the best archer and bower I've ever read in terms of his skills and his character. He's fantastic. And then the final one for that is Mail, I'm not sure how to pronounce it, which is a book with multiple people on the cover, and I've chosen The Henors for this. Spells and incantations. So we've got spell, which is recolor, so use a color wheel and pick a matching color, and I picked almost this exact shade of purple, so it could only be this poison heart. Then the final subject that I've chosen is inscription. So the final three books, the first one is Glyph, which is recollection, to read a childhood favourite. I don't actually own any of my childhood favourites, and quite frankly, I don't really want to be buying more books. So I've decided to go down a slightly different route, and instead I'm going to read a middle grade, because, you know, some child out there might have it as a favourite. And I'm like, well, that's a childhood, even though it's not my childhood, it's a childhood. So I have selected The Icy Pirates as my third and final time that this appears. And I think somebody out there will pick it as a favourite. They have to, right? Then it's inking techniques, so to read a graphic novel, a comic, or a manga. I've picked Die Volume 1. I know nothing about this other than that G from Book Roast herself has recommended it a few times. And it's sort of like sci-fi D&D, I think, something like that. But I'm just gonna read it and see what I think. And then finally, we have a cozy read, and I've picked Delilah Green Doesn't Care, because I've been told by a lot of people that it's a fantastic book, and it does come across as being quite a nice cozy, I can just curl up and read it. And then there is one book that I forgot when I was talking about my books that I have to finish. And for restoration, I forgot to mention the third prompt. So the third and final is to read a book in one or two settings. So another graphic novel, and that is The Magic Fish. I reckon I can do that in one evening. So those are all three of my readathons, and this video is going to be humongous. If you sit and watch the entire thing, I love you, that's incredible. If you've just skipped through to watch the ones that you're interested in, again, thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments which of these readathons, if any, are you taking part in. And if you're reading any of the same books as me this month, again, let me know. Maybe we can do a bit of a buddy read and get through them together, because I really need the help to actually read more this month. So yeah, I feel really motivated. I'm feeling ready. I'm feeling good about this month. I'm really hoping to just get in and read as much as I can and try and get back from this slump that I've been in for so long. Yeah, I'm gonna head off, and I hope you're all good. I hope you're staying safe, and until next time.